Dear students, today we have discussed about the first chapter in physics, that is units and dimensions. Here in our daily life we are using the number of instruments like physical balance, common balance, clock, thermometer, scale, spring balance and weighing machine, etc., for measuring the different physical quantities like weight, mass, time, temperature and length, etc. A physical quantity which can be known by its measurement. Here it is very difficult to understand a physical quantity by knowing simple its properties. For example, we know or to know how to measure a physical quantity. Here the first example, to know whether a person is suffering from fever or not, to measure its temperature. Next, suppose we want to measure the height of the plant, whether it is growing or not, the height of the plant is to be measured by using the scale. Here from this we know without measurement there is no further development in the physics. Here the experiments and measurements are very essential to verify the theoretical laws. Here the necessity of the physical quantities and measurements and their units are discussed in detail in this chapter. Look at the balance. What is the mass of the sugar? Here the mass of the sugar is 2 kg. Look at the clock. What is the time now? The clock shows the time is 2 o'clock. Look at the spring balance. What is the spring balance shows? Here the spring balance shows the weight of the body as 10 kg. Next diagram, here what is the weight of the man? Here the weighing machine shows the weight of the man as 100 kg. We discuss about the units and dimensions. Here from that examples we have to conclusion, there are 3 important quantities in the branch of physical science. These are 3 important quantities: mass, length, time, are known as fundamental quantities. Now we define the definition of a fundamental quantity. A physical quantity which is independent on other physical quantity is known as fundamental quantity. Example, mass, length, time. Next we define a fundamental unit. Here the unit is used to measure a fundamental quantity is called fundamental unit. For example, the unit of a mass is kg, unit of time is second, length measured in meter. Now we define a derived quantity. Already we know the definition of a fundamental quantity and fundamental unit. Now we derive a quantity which is derived from a physical quantity is known as derived quantity. A physical quantity which is derived from other fundamental quantity is known as derived quantity. Examples, area, volume, velocity, density, acceleration, etc. Now we define a derived unit. The unit of a derived quantity is called derived unit, or the unit of a physical quantity which can be expressed in terms of fundamental units is called derived unit. Example, unit of velocity is meter per second, unit of acceleration is meter per second square, unit of density is kg per meter cube. Here there are 3 standardized systems are used to measure the fundamental quantities. They are number 1 FA system, 2 CGS and 3 MK system. In FA system the length is measured in foot, mass measured in pound, time measured in second. In CGS system, length measured in centimeter, mass measured in gram, time measured in second. In MK system, length measured in meter, mass measured in kilogram, time measured in second. Already we know the 3 important fundamental quantities, they are mass, length, time. In SI system there are 7 fundamental quantities and 2 supplementary quantities. The fundamental quantities and their names and unit symbols as shown in the diagram. Here the quantity of name in fundamental quantity, first number 1 length, its unit is meter, symbol m. Second, mass, unit kilogram, symbol kg. Time, third one time, and unit is second and symbol is S. Here fourth electric current, unit ampere and symbol A. Thermodynamic temperature, unit Kelvin and its symbol is K. Next, intensity of light, unit is candela and symbol is CD. Quantity of substance, unit mole, symbol MOL. In SI system, there are two supplementary quantities. They are number one, plane angle, its unit radian and symbol RAD. Number two, solid angle, its unit is steradian and symbol SR. Now, in SI system, the standard definitions are given. Here, we discussed about detail the standard definitions of SI units. Number one, meter. Meter is equal to 1,650,763.73 times of the wavelength of orange red light it is emitted by krypton 36 to 86 in vacuum. Number two, kilogram. Kilogram is equal to mass of platinum iridium cylinder kept at CERN near Paris. Third, second. Second is equal to time taken by 9,192,631,770 cycles of cesium-133 atom. Next, ampere. This is the unit of electric current. Consider two infinitely long parallel conductors of negligible area of cross section separated by 1 meter apart in vacuum. Then the magnitude of electric current passed in these conductors to produce a force of 2×10⁻⁷ newton per meter between them is called ampere. Now we define what is meant by Kelvin. Kelvin is defined as the fraction of 1/273.16 of thermodynamic temperature of the triple point of water. Next, definition of candela. Candela is the luminous intensity in the perpendicular direction of surface of a black body of area 1/6×10⁻⁵ square meter at the temperature of solidifying platinum under the pressure of 101325 newton per meter square. Next, the amount of substance means mole. Mole is defined as the amount of substance of a system which contains as many elementary entities as there are atoms in 0.012 kg of a carbon isotope. Next, definition of radian. Here, the angle subtended by an arc at the center of circle whose length is equal to its radius is called radian. Here we know the 1 radian, the value of 1 radian is equal to the 57 degrees 17 minutes 45 seconds. Steradian. Here steradian is the solid angle subtended at the center by 1 square meter area of the surface of a sphere of radius 1 meter. Next, we know some names of the derived quantities and their units and also symbols. Here the names of the derived quantities as shown in the diagram. Here number one, force, unit is in SI system is newton and symbol N. Energy is measured in joule and symbol is J. And power measured in watt and symbol W. Pressure is measured in pascal, unit is PA. Frequency measured in hertz, symbol is HZ. Multiples and sub multiples. In physics, sometimes we observe a big values and small values. Here the larger and smaller values which can be expressed by adding suitable multiplication factor as prefix. If the multiplication factor is in positive powers of 10 is called multiple. If the multiplication factor is in negative powers of 10 is known as submultiple. We know the meaning of multiples and submultiples. Here the multiples of SI units are tabulated in the following tabular form. Here number 1 multiplier 10 to the power of 18, prefix is known as hexa, symbol is E. 10 to the power of 15 is known as peta, symbol P. 10 to the power of 12 is known as tera, symbol T. 10 to the power of 9 is known as giga, symbol G. 10 to the power of 6 is known as mega, symbol M. 10 to the power of 3 is known as kilo and symbol K. 10 to the power of 2 is known as hecta and symbol H. 10 to the power of 1 is known as deca and symbol DA. Already we know the smaller values in SI system can be expressed in the form of 10 to the power of minus powers. Here the submultiples of SI units are tabulated in the following tabular form. Number 1, 10 to the power of minus 1 is known as deci and symbol D. 10 to the power of minus 2 is known as centi, symbol C. 10 to the power of minus 3 is known as milli and symbol M. 10 to the power of minus 6 is known as micro and symbol mu. 10 to the power of minus 9 is known as nano and symbol N. 10 to the power of minus 12 is known as pico and symbol P. 10 to the power of minus 15 is known as femto and symbol F. 10 to the power of minus 18 is known as atto, symbol A. Already we know the different quantities and their names and units in the SI system. Now we discuss about the advantages of SI system. Here the first advantage of SI system, number 1, the SI system is followed in almost all countries. Number 2, all the derived units obtained by simple multiplication and division within 7 base and 2 supplementary units. Number 3, the SI system is provide common agreed names for derived units, for example Newton, Joule, Hertz, Pascal. Number 4, SI system is comprehensive because it has 7 base units and 2 supplementary units. Number 5, SI system is rational because it observed in itself rationalized MKS ampere system. Now let us we discuss about what is meant by dimension. Here when you are raising the powers of fundamental quantities to obtain a derived unit, then the powers of the fundamental quantities are known as dimensions. Here the clear definition of dimension is defined as the dimensions are the powers to which the fundamental units are required to be raised to obtain a derived unit. For example, velocity. Here we know the definition of velocity is equal to the displacement by time. Displacement means length, time means t. Therefore, velocity is equal to length by time. Here L by T is equal to the L T to the power of minus 1, where the dimensions of velocity in length is plus 1, in time is minus 1. Now we know the definition of dimensional formula. Here the expression shows the relation between fundamental and derived quantities is called dimensional formula. For example, the area of the rectangular is equal to the length into breadth. Here the length indicates capital L, breadth is also indicated capital L, means L into L is equal to the L square. Density, density of a substance is equal to the mass by volume, that is equal to mass M and volume L cube. Here density is equal to M by L cube, it can be written as M L to the power of minus 3. And volume, volume is equal to length into breadth into height. Here L B into H means L into L, that is equal to L cube. After knowing the definitions of dimension and dimensional formula, here the sum of the dimensional formula of physical quantities are tabulated as follows. Here number 1, the dimensional formula of momentum. Here the expression of momentum is mass into velocity. Its dimensional formula is m l t to the power of minus 1. Force, force is equal to the product of mass and acceleration, means mass into acceleration is equal, means here the dimensional formula ml t to the power of minus 2. Next, work or energy. Work means the product of force and displacement. Here the dimensional formula of work or energy is ml square t to the power of minus 2. Next, power. Here power, the rate of doing work or work done per second. Here the work by time is known as power. Power dimensional formula is ml square t to the power of minus 3. Torque, torque or moment of couple. Here the product of force and distance is known as torque. Dimensional form of torque is ml square t to the power of minus 2. Gravitational constant. Gravitational constant g is equal to the force into distance square by mass into mass or mass square. Here after simplifying this expression, here we get the dimensional formula of gravitational constant is m to the power of minus 1 l cube t to the power of minus 2. The seventh one is pressure or stress. Pressure, the expression of pressure is force by area, and dimensional form of pressure is m l to the power of minus 1 t to the power of minus 2. Surface tension, force acts per unit length or force by length. Dimensional formula of surface tension is m t to the power of minus 2. 9. Coefficient of viscosity. Coefficient of viscosity, here it is, its expression is force by area into distance by velocity. Here after simplifying this expression, we get the dimensional formula of coefficient of viscosity is m l to the power of minus 1 t to the power of minus 1. Number 10. Impulse. Impulse, it is the product of force and time. Here the dimensional formula of impulse is ml t to the power of minus 1. Latent heat. Latent heat is equal, means the expression of latent heat is energy per unit mass or energy by mass. After simplifying this expression, we get the dimensional formula of latent heat is L square T to the power of minus 2. Number 12, gas constant. Gas constant, here the expression is obtained by using the gas equation. Here PV is equal to RT, means R is equal to PV by T, means pressure into volume by temperature. After simplifying this expression, we get the dimensional formula of gas constant is M L square T to the power of minus 2 K to the power of minus 1. Now let us, we see about what is meant by homogeneous principle. Here the homogeneous principle means the similar terms in any equation, the similar terms can be added or subtracted from each other, is known as homogeneous principle. After knowing the dimensional formula of different physical quantities, now we studied about the uses of dimensional formula. Here the dimensional formula are used, number 1, to convert the units from one system to other system. Number 2, to check the correctness of the equations, whether it is correct or not. Number 3, to derive the equations connecting different physical quantities. How to convert the units from one system to other system by using the dimensional formula. Here let us, we take example to convert number of dyne in Newton. Here the first dyne, it is the given system, means it is the CDS system, and Newton is the converting system. Here the unit of force in MK system is Newton. Here the solution of problem is dyne is the unit of force in CDS system and Newton is the unit of force in MK system. So the dimensional formula of force F is equal to ML T to the power of minus 2, that is equation number 1. Here we write the data in separately. First we write given system CGS and next converting system MKS. Here the fundamental units of the in the given system M1, L1, T1 and N1. Here the units of CGS, mass, length, time. M1 is equal to 1 gram, length is equal to 1 centimeter, time T1 is equal to 1 second. Number of dynes, that is given 1, means 1 dyne. Here in the MK system, M fundamental units M2 is equal to 1 kg, L2 is equal to 1 meter, T2 is equal to 1 second. Here we have to find the N2 is equal to how much. By using the homogeneous principle, N2 is equal to N1 into M1 by M2 whole to the power of A, L1 by L2 whole to the power of B, T1 by T2 whole to the power of C. Now we substitute the M1, L1, T1, N1, M2, L2, T2 values in this equation. Here N2 is equal to 1 into 1 gram by 1 kg whole to the power of A, 1 centimeter by 1 meter whole to the power of B, 1 by 1 whole to the power of C. Here now we convert the CGS units. 1 gram is equal to the 10 to the power of minus 3 kg, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. After substituting these values, N2 is equal to, means all the units are converted into MKS. Here N2 is equal to 1 into 10 to the power of minus 3 kg by 1 kg whole to the power of A, 10 to the power of minus 2 meter by 1 meter whole to the power of B, 1 by 1 whole to the power of C. N2 is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 whole to the power of A, 10 to the power of minus 2 whole to the power of B, 1 whole to the power of C. Equation number 2. Here compare the powers of similar terms from equations 1 and 2. Here A, power of A is equal to 1, power of B is equal to 2, power of C is equal to minus 2. Here the substituting A comma B and C values in the equation number 2, here we get N2 is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 whole to the power of 1, 10 to the power of minus 2 whole to the power of 1, 1 whole to the power of minus 2. N2 is equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into 1. N2 is equal to 10 to the power of minus 5. We get final value N2 is equal to the 10 to the power of minus 5. Therefore, according to use of dimension means N1 CGS units is exactly equal to the N2 MKS units. Here N1 CGS units is exactly equal to the N2 MKS units. Therefore, the given system N1 is equal to 1 dyne. Here the converting system means MKS, that is equal to 10 to the power of minus 5 Newton. 1 dyne is equal to the 10 to the power of minus 5 Newton. Now the second use of dimensional equations are how to check the given equations. To check the correctness of the equation as follows. Suppose if the equation is given, for example, V is equal to the U plus AT. Here in this method, first we write the dimensional formula for left hand side quantity, physical quantity, and show that the dimensional formula of left hand side is exactly equal to the dimensional formula of each quantity in the right hand side. Means that if V, dimensional formula V is equal to U, dimensional formula of V is exactly equal to the AT. Here first we take an LHS, the dimensional formula of final velocity V, that is L by T, dimensional formula of RHS, first term is U, the dimensional formula of U is L by T, and the second term AT. AT means here A is the L by T square, T is means time, L by T square into T, after simplifying we get again L by T. Means here we observe that the dimensional formula of each term in the right hand side is equal to L by T, L by T. Therefore, LHS is equal to the RHS. Hence, the given equation is dimensionally correct. Now, let us see the third use of dimensional formula here, how to derive the equations. The first of all, here the data is given. For example, to derive the equation for the time period of a simple pendulum T is equal to 2 pi into under root of L by G by the method of dimensional analysis. Here, taking the proportionality constant as 2 pi. Here after reading the given data carefully, here first we identify for which quantity we wants to prove the dimensional equation. Here we wants to prove the dimensional equation for time period T. Here the time T is depends upon the following factors. Number 1, length and acceleration due to gravity G. Here the deriving time period T is directly proportional to the product of the defending factors. That is, the solution can be written as the time period T is directly proportional to the product of eighth power of its length L and bth power of acceleration due to gravity G. Here in mathematical expression it can be written as T is directly proportional to L to the power of A, G to the power of B. After removing this proportionality, we put a constant K. T is equal to the K L to the power of A, G to the power of B. Here where K is equal to, already given in the data, K is equal to the 2 pi. Here T is equal to 2 pi L to the power of A, G to the power of B. That is equation number 1. Here we write the dimensional formulas for given quantities individually, dimensionally. Means we write dimensional formula for each quantity, time period dimensional formula T, M to the power of 0, L to the power of 0, T to the power of 1. Length dimensional formula is L, acceleration due to gravity G, dimensional formula is L T to the power of minus 2. After substituting these dimensional formulas again in this equation 1, here M to the power of 0, L to the power of 0, T to the power of 1 is equal to 2 pi, L to the power of A, L T to the power of minus 2 whole to the power of B. Here it can be written as L to the power of A plus B into T to the power of minus 2B. Here compare the powers of similar terms both sides. a plus b is equal to 0 and minus 2b is equal to 1. Here from minus 2b is equal to 1, we get b is equal to minus half. Next, a plus b is equal to 0. Here we can write a is equal to minus b. Therefore, a is equal to minus half into minus half is equal to the a is equal to half. Here we get a value is equal to half, b is equal to minus 1 by 2. Here again a and b values substitute in the equation number 1. Here we get t is equal to 2 pi into l to the power of 1 by 2 g to the power of minus 1 by 2. Here l to the power of 1 by 2 can be written as root l, g to the power of minus 1 by 2 can be written as 1 by root g. Therefore, t is equal to the 2 pi into under root of l by g. Hence, the equation is proved. While using the dimensional formula, there are certain limits are there. Here, the important limits of dimensional method are listed out here. The limitations of dimensional method. Number 1, if an equation contains more than 3 fundamental quantities, the dimensional method cannot be applied. Number 2, if an equation involves trigonometric ratios, logarithmic functions and exponential functions, the dimensional method cannot be applied. The values of proportionality constants cannot be determined by dimensional method. Number 4, if an equation contains sum or difference of two physical quantities on either side, then the dimensional method cannot be applied. Now let us know about error. Here in the laboratory, we are using different instruments like vernier calipers, screw gauge and other spectrometer and other devices. When our improper uses of instrument, the error is erased. Here the clear definition of error means the definition of error is defined as the difference between the true value and measuring value is called error. Here the reasons. What are the reasons to erase the error in the instrument? Here the error is erased due to various reasons. Here number 1, by using the faulty instrument. 2, noted the readings with parallax error due to faulty calculations. Now, how to avoid the error erased in the instrument? Here the following precautions are taken to avoid the error. By using good instrument, noted the readings without parallax error. Parallax error means due to here the deviate of your eye position when you are observing the readings. Due to visual defect, the parallax error is erased. Made the calculations without mistake and to take the number of readings for the same measurement and count its average. Now we discuss about the types of errors. Here there are 3 types of errors. Number 1, systematic error. 2, gross error. 3, random error. Example for systematic error is least count error. Here when you are using the screw gauge or vernier calipers, here the error is followed systematically, that is equal to the least count. Gross error, that is example for the gross error is spectrometer. Here the in the spectrometer we have the number of adjustments, collimeter, eyepiece and prism table. That's why improper adjustment of the instrument, the error is erased, is known as gross error. Next, random error. Here this error is erased randomly in the instrument. For example, in the voltage stabilizer, we observe the voltage varies due to fluctuations of current. Now students, now we summarize the what are the contents are discussed so far in this chapter. Here we know the definitions of fundamental quantities and definitions of derived quantity and their units. And we know the names of the fundamental quantities in SI system and their units and the standard definitions. Next to here also we know the some of the names of derived quantities and their units and how to express the bigger and smaller values by using the multiplication factor as prefix, means multiples and submultiples. Here next to after knowing the dimensional formula of different physical quantities, we are knowing the how to write the dimensional formulas and their uses and how to convert the units and how to derive the equations and how to check the equations. Next, what means here, and also we know the limitations of dimensional method. Next, here the second content, all what is meant by error and how to count the error and their types. Students, I hope you understood the lesson well. Thank you.
Further clarification, contact the additional secretary, State Board of Technical Education and Training, 7th floor, BRKR Bhavan, Tank Bund Road, Hyderabad, 500063, fax 040-322-0546.